Hello my dear students, today let us discuss about rectangular combined footing. Last class I explained about trapezoidal and step footing. So today let us take the numerical on rectangular combined footing. Proportion a rectangular combined footing for a uniform pressure under dead load plus reduced live load with the following data. Allowable soil pressure for dead load plus reduced live load, that is equal to 180 kN per meter square, and for dead load plus live load is equal to 270 kN per meter square. Column loads are given like this. For column 1, dead load is 500 kN, and for column 2, dead load is 600 kN. Live loads, that is for column 1 is 450 kN and column 2 is 800 kN. Center to center distance of column is 5 meter. Projection beyond column 1 not to exceed 0.5 meter. So this is given. So you have to design the rectangular combined footing. Design rectangular combined footing means you have to find what is the length, dimensions L and B. Okay, so you can see here, this is a combined rectangular footing. Two columns are provided here. The column 1, this is column 2. The load acting here, this is on the column 1 and column 2. This is interior column, this is exterior column. Okay, so this is the outer edge and this is considered as inner edge. Okay, this is the total length, and here it is given center to center distance of the columns is 5 meter. Means here the center to center distance of the column, so this is one column, this is one column, so the distance between the two columns, that is equal to 5 meter. Here this is 5 meter, and projection beyond column 1, this is column 1, projection beyond column 1 not to exceed 0.5 meter. So you have to keep 0.5 meter distance from column 1 to the outer edge. Okay, so it should not exceed 0.5, so minimum is 0.5. And this small q, that is uniform pressure intensity here, which is acting in the upward direction, this is developed from the soil. Okay, QR, this is the resultant column load. Okay, so now let us find what is the length, how to proceed with that. First you have to find dead load plus, first let us take first case, that is this one, allowable soil pressure 180, and for combination is dead load plus reduced live load. What is dead load? For column 1 is 500. So for the column 1, exterior column, Q1, that is equal to 500 plus reduced live load. Reduced live load is means 50% of the live load. In the previous problem also I have considered 50%, because it is mentioned here reduced live load. So 50% of 450, so 450 divided by 2, that is equal to 725 kN. Next, for column 2, that is for interior column, Q2 is equal to 600, this is 600, plus 50% of 800, that is equal to 1000 kN. Okay, now so you know what is Q1 and what is Q2, right? Q1 is equal to 725 kN and Q2 is equal to 1000 kN. This is the calculated column loads. For the first case, that is dead load plus reduced live load. Now, since the interior column carries greater load, because here column 2, it has a load of 1000 kN and column 1 carries 725 kN. Since the interior column carries greater load than the exterior column, the rectangular footing can be provided by adjusting the required projection of the footing beyond the interior column. Okay, so now you have to find what is x bar, where the resultant load exists. So for that, what you have to do, let the resultant of Q1 and Q2 acts at a distance x bar from Q1. Okay, now let us consider the resultant lies here. Okay, we'll find what is x bar. What we can do, we take moment about this point Q1. So what it becomes now, how to find x bar, this you have studied in the last semester's mechanics of solids. How we do, Q2 into 5 and about this point we are taking Q2 into 5 plus Q1 into 0 divided by Q1 plus Q2. That formula you know, no, that is A1 X1 plus A2 X2 divided by A1 plus A2. Same formula here. This is applicable for the load. So what we will get? Q2 into 5 divided by Q1 plus Q2. Q2 is 1000. 1000 into 5 divided by Q1 is 725 and Q2 is 1000. So you get x bar equal to 2.9 meter. Now for uniform pressure intensity, the resultant QR as well as the resultant soil reaction QR act at midpoint of footing length L. Okay. So this is for the uniform pressure intensity, the resultant QR and uniform pressure intensity QR, which is acting at the midpoint. Okay. Midpoint of the footing length L. So what you can consider here, x bar plus 0.5, that is equal to L by 2, means this is QR which is acting at the center. So what is that now? X bar, this is this distance, x bar plus 0.5, that is equal to L by 2, which is acting at the midpoint of the footing. So L is the total length, midpoint means L by 2. So x bar plus 0.5 is equal to L by 2. Or if you simplify this, x bar is 2.9 plus 0.5, that is equal to L by 2. So simplify this, L is by 2 is equal to 3.4, 2.9 plus 0.5. So L is equal to 2 into 3.4, that is equal to 6.8 meter. Now soil pressure is equal to QA into B into L. Okay, so this is nothing but the load into area. Okay, so that is equal to QR. Okay, soil pressure is equal to the resultant load QR. So when you equate this, QA into B into L is equal to QR. So if you write in terms of B, what it becomes, B is equal to QR divided by QA into L. Okay, so QR, that is 1725. Okay, total load, QR is the total resultant load. So 1000 plus 75, 1725 divided by QA, this is the uniform pressure intensity, that is for the first case here. This is for 180, okay, QA, allowable soil pressure is 180. So, let us consider that here, 180 into length. Length we got, it is 6.8. So, we get B is equal to 1.41. So, now the dimension is, it is a rectangular footing. So, L into B. L is 6.8 meter and B is 1.41 meter. This is the size of combined rectangular footing. Okay, now the first part is done. Now you have to check for dead load plus live load. First, here there are two cases, right? First we consider this and we got the answer what is L and B for the allowable soil pressure of 180 kilonewton per meter square. Now you have to check for 270 kilonewton per meter square. That combination is dead load plus live load. So how you can consider now? Check for dead load plus live load. Now let us take this QA dash, okay, because QA we considered 180, QA we considered here 180, so QA dash, that is 270, this value, Okay, here elevable soil pressure 270. QA dash is 270. Then Q1 dash here, because here we consider Q1. Q1 dash is now 500 plus 450, because there is no reduced live load. So the Q1 is dead load plus live load for the first one, column 1. 500 plus 450. Column 2 is 600 plus 800. That is Q2 dash is 600 plus 800. So we get 1400 kilonewton. Now again we have to consider the distance of the resultant of the column loads from the column 1 be x1 bar. Okay. So same method now you are doing for the second condition. So now this is x1 bar. Then what happens? X1 bar is equal to Q2 dash into 5 divided by Q1 dash plus Q2 dash. Means same thing here. We are taking moment about this point. Okay. So now Q2 dash into 5 divided by Q1 dash plus Q2 dash. Same here. Q2 dash into 5 divided by Q1 dash plus Q2 dash. So equal to, when you substitute, Q2 dash is 1400 into 5 divided by Q1 dash plus Q2 dash is 2350, 1400 plus 950. So you get x1 bar is equal to 2.98 meter. Now from the column 1, the location of CG of the footing, that is equal to, it is acting at the midpoint. So L by 2 minus 0.5. Okay, this condition, same condition here we have used L by 2 minus 0.5, that is equal to X bar. Okay, here it is equal to X1 bar. So L by 2, now we know what is L by 2. L is 6.8 divided by 2 is 3.4. minus 0.5 you get 2.9 meter. This is as per the first, referring to the first condition from column 1, location of the CG. But when you calculated this, you get 2.98. So eccentricity of QR with respect to CG of the footing is 2.98 minus 2.9, because there is a small variation. Okay, as per this, when you calculate, we get 2.98, but as per this location of the CG of the footing, you get 2.9. so eccentricity of QR with respect to CG of the footing is 2.98 minus 2.9, that is equal to 0.08 meter. Now we have to check for Q maximum at inner edge. That formula is QR divided by LB into 1 plus 6E divided by L. So QR, that is total load, 2350 divided by L is 6.8, B is 1.41 into 1 plus 6 into E is 0.08 divided by 6.8. So you get 262.4 kilonewton per meter square, which is less than 270, considered QA is 270. So this is okay, it is safe. Now you have to check it for outer edge. So for outer edge, it is same formula, only difference is sign here, minus QR divided by LB into 1 minus 6E divided by L. So QR is 2350 divided by L is 6.8 into 1.41. You get, when simplify, my 1 minus 6 into E is 0.08 and L is 6.8. So you get 27.8 kilonewton per meter square, which is less than 270. So okay, hence the chosen size of rectangular footing 6.8 meter by 1.41 meter is okay. Okay, so like this you have to design. First you design for the condition, the first condition, with the allowable pressure of 180, you will get what is L and B. Once if you get L and B, you can check it for the second condition, dead load plus live load. For that, you have to use this formula, For this, you require E value. To find E value, you have to find what is X1 bar and using this also you have to find what is x1 bar, so that difference gives the eccentricity. Once if you get that, you can substitute in this equation and check whether it is safe or not. I hope all of you understood. Thank you.